Brother John, my prayer for you is that you will have the spirit of Samuel, that as he heard the voice of the Lord calling him, he kept going to Eli saying, here I am. And you've come to St. Luke, you said, here I am, you're here. But may your attitude and your openness be the same as the words instructed by Eli to Samuel, that when he hears the word of the Lord, he would say, speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. May God speak boldly to you, and may you be able, willing, and responsible to share what he gives to you. And may he bless you in all your ways, now and always. Amen.
John, beginning of the Gospel of John, the beginning of the Gospels, those disciples are called and they follow him. It strikes me at the end of the Gospel of John, after Peter's reinstated, Jesus could have said a lot of things, but that inflection point in Peter's life, that inflection point in ministry, Jesus had one thing to say. He says it to you as well, and to me, and to all of us here today. John, Jesus says, you follow me. May he be your center point, and the one who brings you along on this journey with all of us. God bless you in your ministry.
Point of age privilege. Anyone over 88? I'll yield. If not, I'm going to grab it. Jesus said to his disciples, take up your cross and follow me. That's not just poetry. It's clear instruction. Take up your cross and follow me. That's kind of a scary thing if you take it seriously. We're so used to speaking about the cross that we don't take it all that seriously. We just say, of course, yeah, what's new? That's like Peter. Peter thought too, a piece of cake. Give me my sword and I'll take care of the rest. That's not the way it was. Jesus knew that more was involved. Taking up the cross means you're willing to suffer, John. You came to St. Luke not just to see a final stint of ministry before you retire. You came to suffer. Were you thinking about that? That's why I'm here. That's my job. When you're 88 or so, you realize. But anyway, Jesus knew that. And that's why he said something in the very first beatitude. Jesus said at the beginning of his ministry, not at the end, but at the beginning, shortly after he was baptized, he said, blessed are they who know their need of God. You're not going to be able to lead this congregation in the suffering we're all being called to unless we're blessed by that sense, I need God. And that's what you preach this morning. But it's truer even than you thought. It is so true. There is nothing that you are going to do in your ministry that you can do appropriately and properly in terms of taking up your cross and leading all of us on the route, that road of the cross, without you personally having such a personal devotion to Jesus that you realize without him, there's nothing. Only with Jesus. So, Lord Jesus, come upon my brother with your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of comfort, the Spirit of direction, the Spirit of life, the Spirit that guides, the Spirit that knows all things, the Spirit of counsel. Lord Jesus, we are a congregation and a staff that needs you more than anything. We need you, Jesus. Come, Jesus.